You would have seen glossy eyes on runways and high fashion magazines, and it looks absolutely stunning. But are they practical? Hi everyone, it's Smita, and today I'm going to be showing you a hack that you can use to fake glossy lids on hooded eyes without it even creasing. So if you're ready, let's begin. I'm going to start with the base makeup. I already have the Tatcha Dewy Skin Mist on me. This is a luminous mist. And now I'm going to be using the Revlon Prime Plus Brightening Primer and mostly focusing this in areas where I have pores and fine lines. This primer is so beautiful. It has such a beautiful glow, which I personally live for. Super excited to be trying a new foundation today. This is the Reform Liquid Luxe Foundation by Hailey's, who are based in San Francisco, very close to me. I cannot brag enough about this foundation. I'm absolutely in love. The kind of natural finish that it gives is amazing, and it's an oil-free foundation, so it can be worn on any skin type basically, and it gives you that medium buildable coverage, and it gives that beautiful healthy looking glow as you can see on my skin. So if you're looking for that very natural dewy finish foundation, that beautiful glow, then this is it. To add some dimension, I'm going to be cream contouring my face using the Makeup Forever Concealer in the shade Chocolate. I'm going to be using this in the circumference of my face and the hollows of my cheekbones to chisel my jawline as well as my nose. For the rest of the face, I'm going to use a flat top kabuki brush from Doe Color to blend it out, which I've listed in the description box below. It's from the Unicorn set. And for my nose, I'm just going to blend it out with my finger. I'm trying a bunch of new products, and this concealer that I'm using right now is from Amazing Cosmetics. It's the Amazing Concealer, and I'm using the shade Light Beige, and this coverage is insane. I was a little skeptical about the shade because I felt like it's a little bit lighter than what I usually use, but it definitely is a brightening concealer. It has completely covered my dark circles and looks fantastic. Using the Retouch Soft Focus Setting Powder, this is again from Hailey's, I'm only going to set in areas where I tend to crease, basically in areas where I use the concealer and in my T-zone. I don't want to set the entire face because I want to preserve that glow. And again, this powder is fantastic. It's just so easy to work with it, and it's very finely sifted, which makes it very easy to apply, and it looks fabulous. And I'm finishing this up with a setting spray. This is the Benefit Super Setter, again my favorite. I'm going to use this to lock my base makeup in so it doesn't move. I'm going to be keeping my brows looking really soft and nice, so I'm going to be starting with the Laura Mercier Brow Gel. This is a transparent brow gel, and I'm just brushing my brow hair upwards with a spoolie. And then with the Precisely My Brow from Benefit, which is a brow pencil, I'm using the shade 4.5. I'm only going to fill in the sparse areas. Now, as many of you know, I have hooded eyes. Hooded eyes is when your lids are hiding under some extra skin, which is called the hood. So when you look straight in the mirror, you may not be able to see your complete eyelid. The hood creates a fold. So that's where most of the products tend to crease like concealers. Now, if you apply gloss over your lid, it's going to settle in that fold line and it's going to crease. And for that reason, I created this tutorial to show you that you can fake a gloss without it actually creasing. The first step is to use an eyeshadow primer that'll blur and fill in all the lines. And the one that I'll be using is from Smashbox. This is a 24-hour primer, one of my favorites. So I'm just going to be mostly focusing this on that fold line because I want to fill that up so nothing settles in. I'm going to be using my favorite Sweet Talk palette from ColourPop. I'm going to start with West Side with a blending brush. I'm going to use this at the crease as well as lower lash line, very lightly smoking it out so it sets the tone for whatever I apply on the lid. And what I mean by crease here is the new crease that I'm building above my natural crease line. Where the fold is where my crease is because I have hooded eyes. So the new crease will be above that. So we make the lid space appear bigger. A glossy lid has two things. It has shine and it has gloss. So we'll create the shine and mix it with a mixing medium for the gloss. This is such a beautiful eyeshadow. You would have seen me use it multiple times. It's called Side to Side. It has the right amount of shimmer. And this is what I'll be mixing with the NYX Multitasker, which is the mixing medium, which in fact you can also use as a primer. All you need is very little. And with my finger, I'm going to dab this on my lid. As soon as you apply it, it feels a little tacky, but unlike the actual gloss, this dries down. And it dries down pretty quick. So until it dries down, I'm just going to relax my lid, look downwards so I don't create that fold. And once it's dry in about 30 seconds to a minute, then I can just normally open my eyes. I'm just touching to make sure it's dry, and it is. So I'm going to finish up with a coat of mascara. But before that, I'm curling my lashes. And for mascara, I'm going to be using the Roller Lash Mascara by Benefit Cosmetics. Using a highlighter, I'm going to quickly highlight my inner corners. That's pretty much it. And that's how you fake a glossy lid without the gloss actually creasing and creating a mess. And it looks absolutely stunning whether you're on the runway or you're just doing a magazine shoot or you just want to wear it to a special event. Now let's finish the rest of the face. I'm going to be using the Juno palette in Bombshell. This has a bronzer, blush, highlighter, pretty much everything. And I love this, especially while traveling. It's so easy. You can just take one palette to add dimension to your face. I'm going to start with the bronzer just to add some warmth to my face. And then I'm using the blush. I like to use it higher up on my cheekbones rather than on the apples of my cheeks because it gives a more lifted effect. And then I'm going to be using the highlighter on the highest planes of my face. On my lips, I'm going to start with the CoverGirl lip liner in Nude, and then I'm going to top it off with the Milani lip gloss in Whatever. And here is the completed look. Absolutely in love. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up. That'll be very nice of you. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. I post several times a week. For your information and reference, I've listed all the products that I've used in the description box right below this video, along with my social media links in case you plan to follow me there. I love you guys so much, and I will see you soon with a brand new one. Bye, guys.